topic we are going to discuss today is active and passive voice. Voice is the form a verb takes to indicate whether the subject of the verb performs or receives the action. Voice is the form a verb takes to indicate whether the subject of the verb performs or receives the action. There are two types of voice: active voice and passive voice. A verb is in the active voice when the person or thing denoted by the subject is the doer of the action. The subject acts or is active. The sentence that uses the active voice is stronger, uses fewer words, and clearly shows who performs the action. In active voice sentences, the subject does the action. So a verb is in the active voice when the person or thing denoted by the subject is the doer of the action. When the subject acts or is active. For example, John wrote a letter. In this sentence, the subject John is the doer of the action. That is, the subject is active. The verb wrote is therefore said to be in the active voice. In the passive voice when the person or thing denoted by the subject is the receiver of the action. The sentence that uses the passive voice is less direct. The passive is formed by putting the verb to be into the same tense as the active verb and adding the past participle of the active verb. The subject of the active verb becomes the agent of the passive verb. The agent is very often not mentioned. When it is mentioned, it is preceded by and placed at the end of the clause. For example, a letter was written by John. When do we use the passive? We use the passive voice when we want to highlight the object. For example, The Tempest was written by Shakespeare. Here in this sentence, we are more interested in the play than the playwright. Second point, when the doer of the action is understood, or it is people in general. When the doer of the action is understood or it's people in general, we use the passive voice. For example, he was arrested as he broke the coronavirus lockdown rules. So we have not written by the police because it's obvious and understood that the doer of the action is the police. So he was arrested by the police. Next point, in scientific or academic writing, generally while writing lab reports describing scientific procedures, we use the passive voice, and it is done to retain objectivity. We use the passive voice when the subject is very long. We also use it to de-emphasize an unknown subject. We use passive voice when we are more interested in the action than the person who does it. For example, the corona cured patients were sent home. The passive voice is sometimes used to disclaim responsibility for disagreeable announcements. Passive voice is also used when the subject of the active sentence is the indefinite pronoun one. We also use passive voice when we don't know or don't know exactly or have forgotten who did the action. Let's see how sentences are changed from active voice to passive voice in present tense. First example, John writes a letter. It's passive voice. A letter is written by John. Second sentence, it is in present continuous tense. He is singing a song. It's passive. A song is being sung by him. Next sentence. Does the grocer sell tea? It's passive. Is tea sold by the grocer? Next sentence. They have finished the project. It's passive voice. The project has been finished by them. Let's see how sentences are changed from active voice to passive voice in past tense. First sentence, John wrote a letter. It's passive. A letter was written by John. Next sentence, they were making a noise. It's passive. A noise was being made by them. Next sentence. They had not done the homework. It's passive. The homework had not been done by them. Let's see some more sentences. They had won the match. It's passive. The match had been won by them. Next sentence. Did the policeman catch the thief? It's passive. Was the thief caught by the policeman? Were the farmers plowing the fields? It's passive voice. Were the fields being plowed by the farmers? Let's see how sentences are changed from active voice to passive voice in future tense. First sentence. John will write a letter. It's passive. A letter will be written by John. Next sentence. I shall have written the letter. It's passive. The letter will have been written by me. When a transitive verb has two objects, either the direct or the indirect object may become the subject of sentence in the passive. As, he taught them English. The passive of the sentence can be, they were taught English by him, or English was taught to them by him. So when a transitive verb has two objects, either the direct or the indirect object may become the subject of sentence in the passive. Let's see another example. They told me the truth. It's passive. The truth was told to me, or I was told the truth. Prepositional objects may also become the subject. For example, they laughed at him. It's passive. He was laughed at. When the subject is unknown or vague, it remains unexpressed in the passive voice. The agent with by is not needed. For example, people speak English all over the world. It's passive. English is spoken all over the world. Next example. You must answer all questions. It's passive. All the questions must be answered. Here you can see, when the subject is unknown or vague, it remains unexpressed in the passive voice. Let's see how sentences are changed from active voice to passive voice in past tense. First sentence, John wrote a letter. It's passive. A letter was written by John. Next sentence, they were making a noise. It's passive. A noise was being made by them. Next sentence. They had not done the homework. It's passive. The homework had not been done by them.